Hey everybody, thank you so much for watching Yankee Stacking. If you're new to my channel, I appreciate you stopping in. If you're an old timer and you love being able to watch Yankees videos, welcome back. But either way, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do. I'd really appreciate it. Now, I posted a video not too long ago that got a lot of attention. I'm going to stick it right up there. It was the three reasons that I think silver sucks. And oh my word, some of the comments were amazing. Some people thought I really, really hated silver, but I don't. There's some aspects of silver that, you know, have some drawbacks to, say, gold or whatnot. But I really still like silver a lot, and I'm stacking it pretty hard. So, you know, while there may be some other reasons why silver sucks, like its incredible weight, I kind of felt bad for silver. And I decided I need to do a video on the three reasons that silver doesn't suck. So here it is. That's what this video is about. And I'm going to give you some reasons I think you should be stacking silver. Here's the first reason. The silver price is much more volatile than gold. Now, while at first that may sound like a negative, it really isn't. If you're looking to make a much bigger profit on precious metals, silver is where it's at. Let's say gold goes to $5,000-$6,000 an ounce. I think that's possible in the next few years. I really do, especially if we have a crisis. But what if silver at the same time goes to $180 an ounce? That would constitute more than a 10-fold increase. Gold would have to go to $15,000 to equal that kind of increase. I mean, think about it. That's amazing. Silver has a lot of upside. So, historically speaking, silver is much more volatile. Part of that is because the silver market is a lot smaller. The total supply of new silver each year is around 1 billion ounces. And gold is around 120 million ounces. So that sounds like what? The silver market is 8 times bigger than gold? Yeah, but just the opposite is true, right? Because of the massive difference in their price. Silver's price makes the value of their annual supply much smaller than gold. In fact, at the current price, the annual gold supply is like 12 times bigger than silver. Silver isn't just, you know, smaller gold, okay? It has a lot smaller market cap compared to other popular stocks too. Check this chart out. Apple Computer, Exxon Mobil, Procter & Gamble, Bank of America, Disney, some big blue chip stocks there. Look at their market cap. Wow. And there's gold. There's silver. So you could see right now that each of these individual companies has a higher valuation than the entire annual supply of silver. I mean, Disney alone is 15 times bigger. Apple's 56 times bigger. It's huge. And that explains why silver is much more volatile than gold. It only takes a rather small amount of money to go into silver for it to have a much greater impact on its price. More than gold. More than almost any other asset class you can think of. So let's take a look at how gold and silver stack up against each other, okay, over some time periods. The gain from 1970s low to the 1980s high, okay, gold went up 2,328%. Silver went up 3,105%. Of course, let's take a look at the reverse, right? The fall from the 1980 highs to the 1985 low. Here you can see that gold was down 66.5%. Silver, 89.1%. Okay, here's another interesting time span. The gain from the 2008 low to the 2011 high. There's gold going up 166%, and silver 448%. And then after everybody got excited about silver and gold, we went through another drop from 2011 high to the 2016 low. So right here you can see gold off 44.6% and silver off 71.8%. There it is right there, guys. You can see the volatility difference between gold and silver. It's significant. Now, again, as a prepper stacker, I'm not selling anything, right? But if you're into flipping your silver, or if you just want to sell off your stack for whatever reason, the higher volatility in silver also means you have to be a little bit more nimble when it comes to selling this stuff, okay? Silver will sell off faster and farther than gold. So when the bull market looks like it's peaking, that's when you got to be ready to sell. However, if you're comfortable with the higher volatility and buy near the beginning of a bull market, this is the way to go. That extra volatility is going to make you money in your portfolio. Financial institutions, investment houses, they're not investing in silver. Yeah, they invest in gold. They have some gold, you know, as a hedge. But silver, it's largely overlooked. But if that changes, or should I say when that changes, the price is going to explode. All right. Enough of that. That's the first reason. It's volatility. Yeah, you got to be willing to ride out the highs and lows, guys. All right. The second reason silver doesn't suck is it's more affordable. You know the old adage, gold is the money of kings, silver is the money of gentlemen, barter is the money of peasants, debt the money of slaves. It's a good quote, actually. But yes, gold is the money of kings. You want to really invest at least densely, and gold is so yummy. You gotta love gold. There's a lot of good reasons why I think gold is the way to stack. But it's expensive to buy that stuff. Silver, much easier to buy. If you buy physical silver, not the ETF or future contract or all that paper stuff, you can get some of the same benefits that gold offers. Like gold, silver is a hard asset. You can hold it. It's tangible. Oh, that's important. It's important to have tangible assets. It's important to take ownership of that tangible asset. Don't put it in a safety deposit box, guys. Don't pay huge storage fees. Keep it close. Put it in your own private bank. Preferably put it in a safe. But it is a hard asset. It's also money. It's not currency. It can't be created out of thin air like fiat dollars, right? It doesn't depreciate like paper currency, right? Throughout monetary history, this stuff was used as coinage more often than gold, okay? That's why I love this constitutional silver. You know, it's real money. It has no counterparty risk, okay? If you hold the physical silver, you don't have to worry about another party making good on some contract or promise, all right? And its worth has never gone to zero, okay? It's never been defaulted on, okay? You own physical silver, you have really no default risk. So silver, you know, it's so affordable. Like, you know, unlike gold, you can buy this stuff pretty easily as long as you don't pay ridiculous premiums. And for you international people watching my video and my channel, sometimes silver is more expensive than gold, I know. But for us in the United States, you can get this stuff for pretty cheap. Now, the third and final reason for this video that I think silver doesn't suck is that the use of silver as an industrial metal primarily is causing the silver inventories globally to shrink. In fact, check out this graph. Global government silver inventories, less than 5% annual supply. Look at what has happened over the decades. Isn't that absolutely incredible? The silver stockpiles are falling, guys. Gold is actually rising. The miners want to mine gold, and silver is often a byproduct of gold mining. But the difference is huge. It's a behind-the-scenes development that could really have big consequences. Governments and other institutions used to hold really large stockpiles of silver. But today, almost nobody does. They stockpile gold, obviously, but they really don't stockpile silver. Only countries that actually hold this stuff are the US, India, and Mexico. That's pretty much it. And the real reason is they don't have to use them for coinage anymore. We just put base metal in our coins now. And as I quickly mentioned before, silver is an industrial metal. And because of that, the need for it is on the rise. Whether it's electric cars, solar panels, medical instruments, you name it, silver is highly used, especially in electronics. So they're using this stuff up really fast. Again, I get back to the demand on silver. It is low right now, okay? But it won't take much for silver's demand, or I should say the demand for silver, to go up rapidly. This touches again on that volatility point. Whether it's a crisis, a shortage in supply for industry, just investment demand, this is going to shoot the moon, okay? So there you have it, guys. Three reasons why silver doesn't suck. I'm sure there is a whole host of other reasons. Feel free to put them in the comments below, but let's just show silver some love, guys, and make sure you're stacking this. So thanks for watching Yankee Stacking. I hope you enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it. And as always, I hope your day is... I can't do that. And I hope your day is A-okay. All right, we're here at Tim's. Having a great time. Tim's helping somebody out. And I'm with A.B. Silver. How you doing, man?
Good, man. How are you?
You won that.
That's right.
On my live stream last night. That was fun. Good and you times. Wanted a sticker. I'm not exactly sure why, but...
It's the best part.
No, it's not. The silver is the best part, dude. It's great to meet you, man.
Nice to meet you, too.
It's been... It's awesome to meet up at Tim's like this. So, I don't know if anybody out there is in the Southern New Hampshire area and wants to meet up with Yankee at Tim's. I'd love to have you do it. So you're new to our community,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, pretty new to YouTube. About a month and a half or so.
Yeah.
Just kind of making some connections and meeting people and stacking on.
Yeah, it was great to have you on the live stream last night.
Yeah,
that was
good
a
times.
Lot of fun. All right, thanks again.
Nice meeting you.
Have a good one.
You too.